Hello everyone, today I have another custom LEGO weapons review from GI Brick again. These are Brickarms weapons, it's just the GI Brick is the reseller of them. So link will be down below for their website. I got a lot of packs because they came out with a bunch of new weapons. So we'll start with the most exciting pack that I want is always the Zombie Defense Pack. So in this pack, the packs come with these nice little cards. You can see Brickarms, and it's the Zombie Defense Pack. And then just has some stuff on it, barcode probably for them scanning. And then it does come with a Citizen's Brick Zombie Head, which they're printing. I had a couple minifigures I've reviewed about them, so their website will be down below. But let's get right into these. I'm not going to go too in detail with the weapons because there's so many I got to get through, but I will show the Zombie Head. So again, this is a Citizen's Brick Zombie Head. Printing with them is always fantastic. A lot of detail in it. And you can put this on any LEGO body you want. If you want to make them a zombie, just add some gray hands. But that's the head. It's just the front face. So some weapons I already have. I'll just show really quick. So like these two. You like the M21 Sniper. And like a silenced M4 scoped. So I already have these two. I've seen them before. Pump shotgun. These are all on their website. On the GI Brick website. Cricket bat. And these are always like great printing. Or like not printing. Great molding. The molds on all these. Here's a baseball bat. The molds for all these weapons are amazing. Never had any issues. This one's a little newer to me. I don't have a lot of these. These are the Kukri machetes. The Kukris are curved in the end of them. They have a slight bend. But I do like these ones. A machete, which I have a lot of these. It's like the Jason Voorhees machete. Have a lot of these. This is like, I can't remember, this one's called X something on their website. It's a submachine gun. Have a few of these and I like these ones a lot. But again, the mold for these and the detail that they can get into these is amazing. For sure, these are my favorite LEGO weapons ever. Silenced little pistol, like a James Bond pistol, which I have a lot. USP, I think, silenced with a little scope on it. Light laser combo in the bottom. Little dagger knife, which I only have, I think, a couple of these ones now. Scar Heavy. You can see it has a little sight on top. It looks like a scar. This one's new. This could be either a mace or it could be like a spiked grenade. I don't know what it's called on their website. But I don't have any of these. This is the first one actually. It's really cool. Molding on it is amazing. I mean, these are sharp for Legos. You could do some work for sure. P90, which I have a few of these now. I don't think I have these ones. I forgot what this one's called. It's a revolver. It's got a sight on top. I don't think I have this. So this is like a really cool gun. Kind of futuristic a little bit. Just a regular combat knife. I have thousands of these. An M9 pistol, which I do like these ones. This is kind of like the Halo gun, or it's a suppressed SMG. Could be like an MP7, kind of. M16, or an M4. And then, oh, well, this is the M4. This is the M4 carbine now. A little more futuristic. And then I don't remember what this one's called, but this is like a, feel like a futuristic kind of knife. But that's the zombie pack. You can see it comes with a decent amount of weapons and the custom printed head, which is awesome. Next one we'll go into is the value pack 5. There's I think 8 or 9 of these, and you can see, so these are all the weapons it comes with. I was excited to get this shotgun because I've never had it. It's the first one, and I don't think I have the XLR either, or the FMJ, or FMG, sorry. Don't think I have that one. And then I have all the rest, and then it does come with a glow-in-the-dark M16A GL, which is, has the grenade launcher and a sight on top. So let's get open these ones up. Spilling them. So again, comes with all these. And then here's some other packs that you can get on their website. And let's get them all. Oh, these do come with some like rocket launcher pieces. So these brass colored pieces connect with these and they go into one of the rocket launchers that they have. And there's three different heads formed. So there's that round one. There's the like armor piercing one. And the rocket launcher, they actually have blue, green, and red. The color tips. So there's those two, and then there's this one. So those are really cool, and they fit into the rocket launchers, which is really cool. Again, another machete. Just gonna add that to this pile. Another M9 pistol. I don't want this video to be too long, so that's why I'm kind of going through it pretty quick. Those are over there. I really like this gun. This is like the Halo battle rifle. I really like this gun a lot. With in Legos. This is top 10 favorite out of all the ones that they've made. And that's like, they have a bunch of different colors for a lot of these weapons. Here's the Tommy gun. So the Tommy gun comes with a drum mag. You just snap it on there. Kind of shimmy it a little bit to get it straight, but there's the Tommy gun. I have a few of these now. I have one that's an overmold too, which is brown and black. This is like a spy pistol. Comes with like where like a stock arm brace kind of. Comes with a scope, suppressor on it. This is a cool gun though. This is I got this in my last video. This is a Star Wars blaster one. Again, I don't remember all the names. You can check them out on their website, though. Here's like the Type 99 kind of gun. Comes with another mag. And it just kind of sticks into the side. I can push it in all the way. Am I putting it in the opposite side? No, I was putting it the right way. I think I am. Yeah, okay, there you go. A little hard to get in, but that's the type, this is the type 100, not 99. Have a couple of these. So here's the FMG. This is my first one of this one. This is like the Call of Duty gun that everyone loved. You could akimbo these. It's a little fold-out gun. It's kind of like a briefcase gun. Sorry, I did not mean to bump the camera. You can see it has the light on top, little hand holder, little stock, and then it has an extended mag. That's where I was holding it. This is a really cool gun. Here's the glow-in-the-dark gun. I have a lot of these. Don't think it will light up right now. No, it's not gonna. It's not been enough light yet. But this gun's cool. Looking at it in glow-in-the-dark should be pretty cool too. Okay, here's this gun. This is the XLR, and I don't have any of these. This is a Halo gun also. This is from like Halo 4. The enemies use this one. This would be cool in an overmold. Have like the inside red, the like where the shooting is, where it shoots from. This is a cool gun though. Very futuristic. A lot of detail in it. And then to the auger, A-U-G-E-R, auger, sounds about right. It looks like a pump-act shotgun, like the Black Ops 3 shotgun you can buy off the wall in Zombies. That's what it looks like, and it actually really cool, like if it is a shotgun. But this gun, this is pretty much why I bought the pack, was this gun. So, got a good pile going over here. Let's get to the next one, SciFi pack. this is the Brickarms SciFi Weapons Pack 2017 one. And then these are all the weapons it comes with. So out of all these, I have that one's different. That's like an upgrade. No, that's like this is like the pump shotgun now. I think that's why I got this pack. That's the Vector. I have a couple MK44s. That's the Ray pistol from Star Wars. Halo SMGs, the XDMR. I have the XRGs. That's like one of their oldest snipers that they've made. That's like the Halo Battle Rifle 2. Flamethrower, or it could be District 9 guns. I don't think I have a core burner, so I'll go into that. And then I have checked out the XLMD before in my other video. So that's this pack. This one will probably be a quick pack because I have most of these weapons. So again, Vector in my last video looks exactly like it. This is like the RoboCop pistol. What's this one called? This one is the Auto 9, yeah. So it's like a full auto M9, I think. This is the Halo Magnum pistol. Here's the, again, the XMDR or whatever it is. Here's the MK44. This reminds me of, like, the Hellboy pistol, I think. I think I checked this one out in my last video. For sure, I checked out Ray's pistol in the last video, or blaster. This I've checked out before. I'm pretty sure I have a bunch of them. This is the pulse rifle from Aliens. I'm going to set this one aside because I have something pretty cool. Halo SMG right here. This one has like a suppressor on the end of it. Yeah, look. Okay, so here's the pistol, or the SMG. It has a suppressor, and the picture doesn't have the suppressor. Oh, there's two of them. XM7S. And the XM7, did I? Oh, right here. Okay, so I didn't know they... I don't think I have this one. So here they are in comparison. This one has a suppressor and this one doesn't. I did not know they make them like that. That's really cool. This is the XRG, which I think I checked out and it was red in my other video. That's a Halo gun, too. I think I checked this one out. This was in one of the... like Star Wars blaster packs. Looks like a flamethrower. It's got like the canister on the bottom. For sure this sniper is super old, but it's always this would be top 10 because it's like one of my favorites because it was one of the first ones I got. Halo battle rifle or assault rifle, whatever it's called. This is the battle rifle. This is like this Halo 2, Halo 3 one. I checked this one out in my last video. This piece does come off, I think. No, it doesn't. Okay, I thought it came off. This is from Halo 4. It's like the rocket gun kind of thing. So here's the core burner. I think I actually might have one of these. I'm not 100% sure. But this gun's pretty cool. I think I do have this gun. It's got a couple holding points right there, there. Call it on the scope, on the hand, the stock, top of the barrel. But that's a cool gun. And now this is for sure a pump action shotgun because it's got shotgun shells right there. This is more like the Black Ops 3 gun. But if you want to have an in comparison, focus camera. A little different. But again, they both could be shotguns. Okay. Lots of guns. Next one is the Modern Combat Assault Pack. And these are all weapons packs. If you want to get them like this, I think it's a little more affordable. I think there's a lot of the same in this one, too, that I checked out. So here's this one. That's a Honey Badger. I don't have that one. I don't have this one, so I'm going to actually look into this one a little bit. These helmets are really nice. The 1911 I have, Magnums I have, that I just showed the sniper, AKs, or their old AKs, the ARC. That's a new version of the rocket or grenade launcher. I have these ones, that's the ABR, I have a bunch. I have the SAW, M16, HK, I have all these, MP5, and combat SMG, AK with a grenade launcher. I'm going to show these two though for sure. So here's the helmet. These are nice helmets. I already showed the SCAR, M4, AK with the grenade launcher, M16, set that aside. The SAW comes with the box mag for it, and then you can stick it right into the side. They have a couple different versions of these ones, one with a shorter barrel, one with a scope on it. I do like these ones a lot. The 1911, I think I have a lot of these ones now because I like them a lot. MP5 for sure have a lot because these are from their original when they used to make them a long time ago. This is the Styrog, that's what it's called, I couldn't remember the name. Foregrip, light on the bottom, scope, how it's always been. The M16 with grenade launcher. I have a glow-in-the-dark one now too. Sniper rifle I just showed. Magnums, I have a bunch of these. It's pretty simple. AKs. Have thousands of these. So the grenade launcher, I think this is a different kind of... has a little more detail. But it has its grenade holders right here. Then it connects in just like the Tommy gun. Snaps right in. And it swings out so you could act like, you know, you're reloading it with the minifigures. Has a scope, stock. I have the older ones, just the grenade launcher, but not the version 2. Have to look at a comparison to see any difference in them. But these two I'm excited for. So this is like the Honey Badger, or like an SBR. It's got a shorter barrel than most of the guns they have. It's got an angled foregrip, red dot sight. Look at how the stock is. That's very unique. Then on this side, really cool. Really happy with this one. And then now this just came out too. This is the FAL, and this was sold out, so I had to get the pack. It's called something else. It's called the NATO BR, so NATO Battle Rifle. But you can see, it looks exactly like the FAL. It's got the, I can't think of the name. Where you rack it back to load it in. It's got a carry handle on it. The minifigure, I don't think can hold it, but it's like molded into the gun. Foregrip on here, longer barrel, long mag in it. Or how the mag is. It just seems longer than most of the ones that they have on a lot of their guns that they make. But this is a really cool gun. Very happy with getting that one. Okay, I got two more things. So this is another weapons pack again. This one now is the Modern Combat Tactical Weapons Pack, I think. So they are different. So this was... the one I just looked at was the Modern Combat Assault. This is the Tactical. Yep. So a little different. Oh, I didn't show what it comes with. So this one comes with another 44 RMR, little AK, P90. This gun I've showed before. The XMP I just showed. Have that helmet just showed. Old. That's a really old shotgun. Spy Carbine I've showed. That's the Barrett 50 cal. M9 I showed. Showed the M110 USCS pistol I have. This gun's new, so I'll show that one. Vector FMG. Oh, there's the other SAW, so this is the 249 para. And then it comes with a little flashbang. So, let's dump this one out. So, Barrett 50 cal, which I have 100 of these ones too. Looks exactly like the gun. There's that one. Here's the Spy Carbine again. There's the helmet. This one's in black instead of tan. Just already showed this the sniper before. Another M9 pistol. Here's the little AK-47U or 74U. It's got a little skeletonized stock. The Vector again. FMG. I can now have a Kimboto. P90. Okay, I'm gonna set this one aside because that's one I want. Here is the 249 para. So this one has a skeletonized stock, has the scope on it. This is a little different. Meant to be like a lighter gun, I assume. This gun I have checked out before. This was in the Brickmania Spec Ops kit. If you want to check that one out, it'll be right up here in the corner. Link will be down below also, but that's this one. It's a little bit of a tactical M4. It's got a scope where you can zoom in on the sight, foregrip, flashlight, suppressor, different kind of style stock. The RMR pistol again. The submachine gun that I looked at already. This is a M16 with a pump shotgun on the front. The little flashbang. Oh, I almost dropped it. Kind of hard to see in my hand. There we go. And I dropped it. The pump shotgun with a scope on it. Have a lot of these. These are one of their older ones, too. They also make them without the scope. And then the UCS pistol. So here is the... This is the L85A1. So it's a bullpup style rifle. Has a scope, a little longer of a barrel. You can see where the little mag's in the back right there. This gun I wanted, so I had to get the pack again. Cool gun. It's going to be good, look good on a lot of minifigures. It's a British gun, I think. Okay, I got a couple more to get through. These are now newer versions of older versions that they've come out with. So these, so here's the, this is the M16 with the shotgun and with the grenade launcher. They're white because they were, you get freebies with your purchases all the time. And then also here's a blue RPG, which I have. Again, this was a freebie, so they just give them to you. I think I checked out the STG last time. It's just I liked it a lot, so I got some more. So this is like the version 2 of them. I think I only got one of them in this pack. Yep. Okay, so here is what I want to show. This is the Pulse Rifle version 2. Now, if you can just see all the detail on this one, it's got the pump shotgun on it this time on the bottom. You can see it's ported up there. It has the slide to pull it back. How the stock is, how the front barrel is for the Pulse Rifle itself. This is actually based off the Thompson. That's how they did it. It was a Thompson lower body, and they kind of like added to it. That's how the gun was made for the movie purposes of Alien. And then here is the version 1 side by side. I kind of hold them in the like this. So you can just see they are very different now. This one doesn't have even have the shotgun on the bottom of it. This one has just a lot more detail, the version 2. So it's cool to have some newer, updated guns that they're doing, you know, from the older ones. Here's another Honey Badger gun. So I got two of those now. And then I just showed this one. This is the bullpup gun. So I got two of them. I guess I didn't need it in a pack. I guess I bought it separate. I got a single, the M4 again with the attachments again. So this one I'm excited about. They brought back, or they made a version 2 of the MP44. I don't have the version 1 on the table, so can't show the comparison, but this is a gunmetal one. You can just see all the detail. It looks exactly like the real steel firearm that they make, or have. It's a World War II German gun. I also got it in black because I anytime I get the new ones come out, I always want to get two and hopefully get them in two different colors. So just the black version of it. This one I'm excited about. Forgot what it's called, but it's a very big LMG. I don't think there's mags with it. Nope, this is how it came. Very big LMG. It's got a, you can put this in like Lego pieces or sets where they have the holes and it can be like a mounted machine gun. But it's a really cool gun. This is one of the newer ones that came out recently. This piece can come off and go on a lot of other brick arms that they make. But it's really cool. It's a big gun. I just dropped it. It's a big gun for a minifigure. I'm not going to pick it up right now. And then now they also have version 2s of the PPSH. So I got two of those also. So again, you just snap on the drum mag. And here it is. Now I can tell this is updated because the drum mag's different, how it clips on's different. And then there's a little more, the details are a little deeper in the gun. So really cool. And then I also got it in black. So let me open this one really quick. So here is the... snapped it on. Here's the black PPSH. The other one was gunmetal. Again, I like to get two of them when they're new. So that was this Brickarms haul from GI Brick. I'm picking up the gun. Hold on. Okay. A lot of them you can see. A little bit quick, but just want to get through them, not to make too long of a video, even though I'm talking and it's making it even longer now. The newer guns are probably my favorite out of this giant bundle of guns that I got, and the zombie head from Citizens Brick. Again, links will be down for all the packs that I've just showed. Not the single weapons, those you can just go to weapons on their website and pick which ones you want to get separately. I think the weapons packs are a little more like you get more for your dollar, kind of. And if you want the zombie head, you got to get it with the zombie defense pack. That's the only way to get it. Or you might be able to get it on Citizens Brick. Yeah, it says it's printed by them, so I'm pretty sure you might be able to find the head on their website. But if you want to check any of these things out again, links will be down below for all of them, for GI Brick, for Brickarms, and Citizens Brick also. And then if you haven't already, you can check out my other Brickarms video and the Brickmania video, because they have Brickarms in it, and I'll put my Citizens Brick videos up here too as well, so you can check out all those. If you like the video, leave a like, it helps me out. Don't forget to subscribe if you're not already subscribed. We are almost to the 50 mark and I'm excited, and then that will be my halfway goal to getting to my next one. So again, subscribe, leave a like, comment down below any Lego items you'd want me to review next, or custom Lego items, anything Lego related. And as always, thanks for watching.